0843. Call today to see if you qualify at 1-800-530-0843. Call now.
We all fall in love. And we all get colds. Hopefully not on the same day. Thank goodness for Kleenex tissues. Ultra soft, 3-germ blocking layers help you share feelings, not germs.
I want to make more money.
I want more leisure time.
I want the American dream.
Greater income and freedom can be yours. And Debit Corporation of America has the key. Your own wholesale distribution business.
I want to be my own boss.
I want to feel good about what I do.
I want to kiss the rat race goodbye.
Debit Corporation of America has an opportunity now that you must explore. A turnkey operation that can give you greater income and freedom than you've ever known. Call now for all the facts and turn your life around.
I want to call the shots.
I want to be able to take time off when I want to.
I want to change my life.
Discover a ground floor opportunity that can put you in control of your life. For your free information package and video, call now and see how you can give your family everything you've ever dreamed of. The call is free, so don't delay.
I want an end to my financial worries.
I want the American dream.
And I want it now.
For an incredible business opportunity and a new life, call Debit Corporation of America. Areas are selling fast, so call now.
I'm going to call today.
Tomorrow. Brace yourself for Storm Stories, a race against time.
You need to get the mother and the child in the basket now.
As a river rages out of control.
The river was washing away the house.
Plus, it's been called the storm of the century.
It was no normal storm.
Do you see how this superstorm devastates 800 miles from Florida to Maine? Watch a new series from the Weather Channel, Storm Stories, tomorrow at 8 Eastern.
Now, from the Weather Channel, here's your local forecast, always on the 8s of every hour.
Philadelphia, over a foot of snow is on the ground. The snow showers, heavy ones, are further to our north, but those of you in Boston just beginning to see some of the heaviest snow to come. The ice is still a major problem in the Carolinas, and Raleigh is at near a standstill because of the ice. It's not going to stick around much longer. Some warmer conditions in the forecast for you in the Carolinas. Hello. Thank you so much for joining us here at the bottom of the hour. I'm Lisa Moser. We are in alert mode here at the Weather Channel, and that is because of the northeast conditions. 2 feet of snow easily across many of the major cities. And the storm is not over yet. Let's begin with some of the numbers, very impressive numbers. Baltimore, a really big snow for you, perhaps one of the biggest in history on record, 26.6 inches of snow. Alexandria, Virginia, 18.7 inches of snow. Washington, D.C., now coming in at 16.1 inches of snow. Dover, Delaware, 21 inches of snow. New York City at Central Park, 18.5 inches of snow. That's a lot of snow. Our winter weather expert, Paul Kosin, has been monitoring the situation and is going to tell us more about what Boston can continue to expect. Paul?
Well, it looks like Boston's going to be receiving just what all the others are going to be getting, which is now blizzard conditions, blizzard warnings in effect. That means winds gusting to an excess of 35 miles per hour, heavy snow with visibilities less than a quarter of a mile for a period of at least 3 hours will be met in the Boston area this evening as the storm system continues to move. Look for 12 to 24 inches by the time this long, drawn-out storm system comes to a close tonight. Let's take a look at the radar we can take before we get to Boston. We can look at New York. There was a disturbance that came through that almost looked like the end of the storm. It's called a gravity wave that punched a hole in the snowfall, but we've seen when these wave disturbances come through, it prematurely ends the snow, and then snow fills back in. We're seeing that right now, and in New York, we're seeing the back edge of the snow continuing to reform. So even though New York has had at least their fourth largest snowfall, they're eyeing in on their third and second, which happened to be from the blizzard of 96 and the blizzard of 88. So as they're nearing 19 inches, they're approaching these snowfall records of around 20 inches or 21 inches. And they stand a little bit of a shot as snow will pick up for the next few hours before it finally tapers off this evening. There still could be some light snow even overnight as the storm system continues to raise havoc along the mid-Atlantic coastline. So we can see all this tremendous vertical motions in the atmosphere rising this way and rising in that way. All of that is creating a tremendous band of precipitation from central New York into New England. That's going to be spreading off towards the northeast tonight. The main problem with this storm system, it's moving very slowly off to the west. And here we can even see an upper-level disturbance that's coming in from the west. That could also produce some light snows continuing, even from Washington up to New York, later tonight into tomorrow. Though those amounts should be light. The main focus is going to be tonight in the Boston metropolitan area, as well as Hartford and Providence, where you will also see similar amounts that we're seeing all the way down here, generally 1 to 2 feet of snow likely, and that's associated with this lovely-looking coma cloud, where all this transition zone here represents tremendous rising motion of air, and that's where some of the heaviest snows are found. That will be moving across New England as the storm continues to develop overnight. Not a very intense storm system, although you'd never know it. It's that interaction between a large surface high and a slow-moving low-pressure system that's bringing all the snow, the wind, and the moisture towards New York and New England. That's going to continue this evening as the story moves from New York towards New England and upstate New York tonight. Lisa?
Best bet is to stay inside from New York to Boston for today, at least, Paul.
I don't think people are going to have much of a choice, to be honest, Lisa.
Thanks for the update. Paul Kosin, our winter weather expert. Paul is from the D.C. area, knows this type of weather pattern from firsthand as well as from his profession. Just looking at a few more very impressive numbers, some really big snowfalls. Champion, Pennsylvania, 40 inches of snow. Terre Haute, West Virginia, 40 inches of snow. This is right along the Panhandle area. Garrett County, Maryland, 40 inches of snow. As Paul did indicate, we've got a walloping area of low pressure that's really pumping in the moisture. It's slow to move, and that's what's creating those blizzard and blizzard-like conditions across you in Connecticut and also Massachusetts. But the upper-level low feature is still back here waiting in the wings to give us a second dose of snow shower activity through the day tomorrow. Now, it's only likely to see a few inches of accumulation, but still, we don't really need any more snow. We're going to get some more. The wind, it continues to blow and drift a lot of snow around across the Jersey area, Pennsylvania, Long Island. Seeing some of the winds in the last hour up around 30 to 35 miles per hour. Lots of snow being driven by these 40-mile-per-hour winds that are now beginning to come into play here across the extreme eastern areas of Cape Cod and the Massachusetts vicinity. 27 degrees in Boston, it doesn't feel like it. The temperatures actually feel about 10 to 15 degrees colder. That's that wind driving those temperatures to feel so much colder. But it's a cold air mass in place. We saw some record cold temperatures this morning, but Caribou, we are now up to 7 degrees at this hour. Tomorrow, we'll see more of a southwesterly flow coming into the Mid-Atlantic, so we may be looking at a little more of a slushy scenario as that new snow comes our way. We will be looking at the temperatures make it above the freezing point, at least for a short period of time. We are getting very close to that melting freezing point across much of the Carolina vicinity. And as you know, Raleigh, we saw so much ice and sleet yesterday. It was just absolutely a bear to try and be out on the roadways. Even the major corridors were just lined up with accidents, and still travel is not good. We're up to 30 degrees. If we do see the temperatures warm up a couple more degrees today, we still have the freezing temperatures tonight that threaten to refreeze everything, so travel still should be limited across the Piedmont of North and South Carolina. We'll be back. More details, your locals on the 8th.
Think all mortgage lenders are the same? Think again. At DITEG.com, there are two fast and easy ways to apply for a home loan 24 hours, 7 days a week. You can pick up the telephone and call our toll-free number or apply online at DITEG.com. Right now, you can apply for a low fixed-rate mortgage or cash out some of your equity. There's no advance fees prior to closing and no cancellation fee. DITEG.com. There is a difference. Call 1-800-71-FIXED.
From generation to generation, some things never change. At New York Life, it's our values. Financial strength, integrity, and humanity. Values rooted in our tradition as a mutual company, serving only the interests of our customers. Values that make New York Life the company you keep.
Call to find the New York Life agent nearest you. New York Life, the company you keep.
There's a reason RE/MAX agents average more sales than other real estate people. RE/MAX agents want every transaction to be as perfect as possible. With all their experience, they know that a little extra effort can make a big difference to sellers and buyers.
Can you fly?
RE/MAX. Outstanding agents. Outstanding.